have a packed house here for the first event of the 2021 Marble Champions League. As we welcome you inside of Marble Fubica Stadium, you have a look at our gigantic trophy here for our winner, which will be determined not today, but a little bit later on. We've got 12 teams competing. We've got fans from all 12 teams from across their countries and across the world here to see today's first event, as well as some fans who are just in it for the fun. Hello again, friends. I'm Keanu Bittersey, glad to be here on behalf of Marble Fubica for today's coverage of our first event of the 2021 Marbles Champions League. In just a few moments, you're going to see all 12 of our teams that are competing make their way onto the stage and get a chance to show themselves in front of their fans and in front of the entire world watching today. Said 12 teams competing to be named the ultimate Marble champion. Let's meet the teams. Nobody knows how to do an opening quite like Marble Fubica here at the Marble Fubica Stadium. It was an exciting moment just moments ago as these teams made their first appearances in front of their fans. You see some of those amazing marbles, the different designs and the great logos for these teams as they were getting a chance to become acquainted with these fans who will watch them over the next few weeks, find their favorites, and root for their ultimate winners. The teams are ready. The fans are ready. We are ready. Let's go. It's event number one. This is Target Shooting. So you look inside of today's event stadium, where we will be doing target shooting, as we just said. We're in the main lobby moments ago. Now we turn our eyes toward center court. An opportunity for these 12 teams to make their first impressions in front of their fans. There are the pins, those orange pins that they will be shooting for. There are 21 pins, so an opportunity for 21 points. Similar to the way that you would score in bowling, you're looking to knock down those pins just like you would in bowling. There is the single lane course, which includes an upward hill that they're going to go over. I believe there's a shooting mechanism inside of that tunnel there, which should help with some speed. It'll be interesting to see, as there are seven different levels on this pyramid here where our pins are located. We're going to try to see where is the best location. If you've been with us for a while here on Marble Fubica, you know how the tournaments work. There are four groups, group A, B, C, and D. Top two will qualify from each group, move into two semifinals. The top two from each of those semifinals will advance into the final round, where they'll place first through fourth. First team out of the gate, Group A, it's the Archangels. Here we go. And a score of 19 pins down, so 19 points on the board for the Archangel. Let's have a look at the replay here. A great slow-mo. There are six levels there, and it looked like that was a hit on the third level, a little bit off to the right side. So not exactly even from the Archangels, but still 19 points. Can't do a whole lot better than that. So a strong start for the Archangels. We'll see if that's enough to survive Group A. But a strong start for them, as the Savage Jackal will be the next to go. And they are released. And a score of 15. They left some to be desired there. Six pins on the bottom left alone. Let's see. That was a little bit too high. In between the second and third levels there, didn't have enough of a centralized location there for the Savage Jackal, so they leave a little bit more to be desired. and score 15. They move into second here with the Vikings, and they will pick up 17 points. And with that, the Archangels are locked into the next round, and the Savage Jackal are out. So it'll come down to the Vikings, as we'll have a look one more time at their replay. It looks like it's very similar to what the Archangels put up, just a little bit higher. And so it didn't get a whole lot of contact with those bottom two layers. Had to rely on pins falling on top of pins. Worked out a little bit better than the Savage Jackal, but not as well as the Archangels. Last team up is the Janitors here in Group A. Let's see what they can do. They're up, they're through, and it's a clean sweep. 21 on the board for the Janitors. They're through. Advancing with them are the Archangels, and the Vikings and Savage Jackal are eliminated. Let's see where the Janitors located this one. Looks like it's perfect, right in the middle between the bottom two rows there, and you can't do it a whole lot better than that. The Janitors off to a strong start with 21 points and did it in 2.7 seconds. It was the slowest run, likely because they were the lowest where they made contact with the pyramid there. So advance the Archangels and the Janitors into the first semifinal. And Group B now will begin with the Steel Brothers. We'll see what they can put forward. They're off. And through, and they have a clean sweep. 21 points on the board for the Steel Brothers. A time of 2.667. Let's see where they made contact. Was it the same as just moments ago? Looks pretty similar. A little bit further to the right side there, so it wasn't as even in terms of being centered up, but still worked just as well. A lot of speed carried, and the Steel Brothers off to a strong start, likely advancing into the next round. But you never know as we move on to Tatu Bola. Stands for the three balls. Let's see what they can do. They're hoping they're going to score more than three. They didn't score anything. Oh my, it's a clean miss from Tatu Bola. And they are in trouble. Wow, that is extremely disappointing. So they are almost guaranteed to be eliminated, as here are the Trojans, and they pick up 19 points. So that'll move Tatu Bola out of here. We'll lock in the Steel Brothers, and let's have a look at this replay here for the Trojans, see how it worked. Looked like a little bit better location than... ...than we've seen on a couple of these, but only able to even what the Archangels did at the beginning of this tournament in Group A. The Trojans are on the hot seat here. Can they advance, or will it be Swiftblade? We'll see what they can do. They are released from the holding cell. Off they go, and a clean sweep. They do it in a time of 2.753. They take the second transfer spot. The group win will go to the Steel Brothers, but Swiftblade puts up our third clean sweep out of the first eight competitors to go. And you can see a pretty solid run there. So eight teams done, eight teams to go. I misspoke earlier and referred to our tournament with 12 teams. It's 16. Obviously, I mentioned them all, just got the math a little wrong there in my head. 16 teams, 8 down, 8 to go. Here's the Lynx Ruffus. And, oh, that was interesting. We'll have to have a look at this and see what the replay shows us. Almost looks like they missed. Let's have a look. They put up 16. Sure enough, they didn't make contact with any of the pins. Made contact with the surface that's holding the pins together enough to kind of ruffle them around, and a few of them fall, and a pretty good score there, considering the fact that they didn't make any contact whatsoever with a single pin. 16 points on the board. Here's Flush. And they will knock down all 21. Certainly made contact there as we have a look at this replay. Not very solid contact, though. So Group C has done it in different ways than our first two groups did. Making pretty solid contact with the pins early on were the first two groupings. Not the case, though, in this Group C. One completely missed, but got away with 16 points. The other, not a super solid contact, but all 21 pins are down. Here's the Snow Wolves, and they put up 20. So the Snow Wolves in a strong position. The Lynx Ruffus, they are going to be eliminated here in the group stage. Flush is officially in, and it will come down to the Snow Wolves. 20 points, can't do a whole lot better than that, so they are in a pretty good spot, but you've seen it's not impossible to score these strikes, for lack of a better term, as the Speedy Hunters will try to do just that and advance into the semifinal, and they'll come up just short. 19 points on the board, not good enough. As we look at the replay and see where could that last pin have come from. Oh, wow, you can see the one that's on the left there kind of wiggled a little bit. Couldn't get it done, and so the Flush and the Snow Wolves advance to the semifinal. And this will bring up our final group. Here is Orus 1. And they knock down all 21. A pretty common theme. Seems as though it's not too incredibly difficult to hit them all, which means that you might get a time tiebreaker at some point later on here. And that one looked very similar to the first 21 we scored at the beginning of this matchup, and that was a pretty solid one there from Orus 1. That will bring up now Onyx. And they put up 18 points. Left three on, a little bit off to the right side. That was perfect location in terms of height, where you want to put that in between the first and second level seems to be the way to go, but off to the right side caused a little bit of a problem. They move to 18 points. Here are the Blue Jackets. Looked like they were moving a little slow there. Yeah, no, actually, in fact, they had the fastest run. Because it just looked a little strange there, and they put it right in the middle, put up 21. They are in now because of that time tiebreaker, so Orus 1 is not technically in. Onyx is out. And now it'll be up to the Sphery Spiders to determine our last member of the semifinals. They're going to knock down 17, and I don't think they hit any of the pins either. Yeah, again, they make contact with that surface that's holding up the pins, and the vibrations there able to knock down a few, but not enough. And so we will not see somebody that knocks down all the pins not advance. It got close there at the end. If they had knocked all of them down, somebody was going to not fail at all, but yet not make it into the next round. As our semifinals are set now, Group D advances Orus 1 and the Blue Jackets. There are the semifinals, A and B. And so the semifinals begin again where we started the first round with the Archangels. They're off and running, and they put up 20. You can see that one lone pin that stayed up at a of a hard time remaining on the platform there. In fact, it looked like it was off just a little bit, but not enough to be able to, yeah, as you can see there, not enough to be able to actually knock it off. And so they put up 20. Here are the Janitors who had the first 21, and they just missed. Happens for the second time. A complete whiff from the Janitors, who were so strong in their first group matchup. Let's see how close was it. Not very close at all, it seems. Hard to tell the depth perception there, but it looked like they may have just missed it pretty badly. Here's the Steel Brothers. They put up 21 as well, and they'll put up 19 this time. So that will move the Archangels into the final. First team to go will seemingly be the first team to go all the way into the final. As they advance with a score of 20, the Steel Brothers are in a strong position, but certainly not guaranteed. Here's Swiftblade. Let's see what they can do. They need a big score, and they get it! 21 for Swiftblade. They're advancing. The Archangels pass with 20, and it's a score of 19 for the Steel Brothers, but they are not going to advance into the final. Swiftblade left one on the platform there, but what you need to do is knock it off. In terms of, or knock it over, I guess I should say. And that's what they did. It was laying on its side, so it counts as a point. Either way, they would have advanced. But Swiftblade is through. Into our second semifinal, we begin with the Snow Wolves. And they put up 21. Another strong run. And perfectly done. That is where you want to go, in the middle of the either bottom row or right in between the first and second levels. There is really where you want to be. Let's see what Flush can do to try to answer that score of 21. They went a little bit too high. They'll pick up 18. The snow... Wolves are through, and you can see, like I said, you want to be between levels 1 and 2. Meanwhile, they're all the way up there in between levels 4 and 5. That's pretty high, and in fact, that's a pretty good score for how high of a contact location that was for Flush. But they do put up 18. Not a bad score at all. Here's Oris 1, see what they can do. And they're going to put up 20. So that will eliminate Flush. The Snow Wolves are through. Just left one on there. Will that come back to haunt Oris 1? We'll find out. The Blue Jackets hope it does. And it will! The Blue Jackets put them all down, and they advance to the final. They will join the Snow Wolves out of semifinal B. And it is the one pin that Oris 1 left on the board that will come back to haunt them as they will finish in the second grouping. Unable to get to the finals. That is a disappointing end for Oris 1, and in just such a disappointing fashion. So the Snow Wolves and the Blue Jackets advancing into the final here of target shooting. And a very up and down. We've seen a lot of 21s. We've seen a couple of zeros. Here's the Archangels, and they will put up a modest 17. I don't think that's good enough, to be honest with you. Certainly not going to be enough to win it for the Archangels. See if they can maybe place on the podium for second or third. Obviously, there's that awkward fourth place finisher who gets to the final but doesn't get to be put on the podium there. Here is Swiftblade. I hope that they're not the one that has that happen, and they won't be. 21 for Swiftblade. They're in the driver's seat. And keep an eye on the time. Not the fastest time by any stretch. A 2.753. Was faster than the Archangels, but certainly not the fastest time we've seen. And it might come down to that if you get multiple that are going to score all 21. Let's see what the Snow Wolves do. Swiftly trying to hold on to the lead. There is 20 points on the board. And Swiftblade remains in the lead. The Snow Wolves take over second. They guarantee themselves a podium finish. They will not win. And looks like it was just a little bit too low and off to the right. And I think that it may have been, yeah, it was one of those two pins that are right in the middle on the bottom row that stayed. Last hope is the Blue Jackets. Will it be Swiftblade or the Blue Jackets? They are off, and they missed it. And the Blue Jackets, with our third whiff of this tournament, it will cost them a spot on the podium. But they do finish fourth. The Archangels slide into a bronze. Silver for the Snow Wolves, and of course, Swiftblade with a very strong statement. You see their fans are excited. Cheering section going crazy with the Swiftblade flags. Very nice touch there by that fan base. They were ready, hoping to see their team do well, and they did. Swiftblade wins event number one, target shooting of the 2021 Marble Champions. As you have a look at the results, Swiftblade, Snow Wolves, Archangels, Blue Jackets, Oris 1, the top five go all the way down to Tatu Bola, who finishes last, does not score a point. Savage Jackal picked up just 1 point. And a disappointing start. Here are the overall standings. Swiftblade, the Snow Wolves, the Archangels, the Blue Jackets, Oris 1, Steel Brothers, Flush, the Janitors, Trojans, Speedy Hunters. That's the top 10. Eye on our podium finishes. Those will show up at the end of every event, showing you how many medals have been won, as well as how many first place finishes for our different teams. But ultimately, you want to have the most amount of points. We've seen that in previous events here on Marble Fubica, different tournaments in which it's not necessarily just about wins, but it's about consistency. Congratulations to the Archangels. They finished third. A silver for the Snow Wolves, but today they all aspire to be Swiftblade. 20 points, a gold medal, and the lead in the championship standings. They are automatically now, after one event, they are the team to beat.
Jugar con mis ilusiones, porque cuando se te antoja rompes, eres mi talón de Aquiles. Mi punto más vulnerable, ser un muñeco de trapo.
ojos de botones. Afortunadamente, imposible es que no duela despertar de un cuento de hadas y llorar al darme cuenta que amo un maní.